gentlemen, once again, thank you for joining in the podcast by hospitalityconcert.com, where we officially talk about everything hospitality. I hope you guys liked our previous podcast about life of hoteliers after coronavirus crisis. But if you have missed listening it, then don't worry, we have every podcast available on our website. Simply tune in and keep learning, keep growing. Now, moving on to the topic of today's podcast, which is best decisions to make as a hotelier. Specifically, today's podcast is focused on what kind of decisions we should make to propel our growth journey in hospitality industry after this pandemic time. Now, today we are about to give you 7 best strategies to implement as a hotelier, but as soon as possible. So, without wasting any time, let's dive into the details. The first decision would be give importance to networking. I have said this thing earlier in many podcasts, but today, in hospitality, networking plays a very important role. Having good connection with seniors and hospitality leaders would give you access to vast amount of opportunities. This hard time has shown us the importance of networking. So many people have lost their jobs and they don't know how to get another one. Now the people who have access to good network, they didn't actually suffer to get themselves a new job, because they have access to lot of people who are looking for the talent in the market. Networking wouldn't only help you with jobs, but it will help you to develop your personality, your interpersonal skills, your communication. It will improve the way you engage with people. It will help you to showcase your talent to the masses. And in this digital era, building a network is not as hard as it used to be earlier. You only have to find a relevant channel for networking. For an instance, you can use LinkedIn and simply start connecting with the people who belong to the same industry as you are. Connect with the people who are having same field of interest as yours and try building a professional connection with them. It will definitely help you in the long run and sometimes when you need it. So, note down the first decision to make. Give importance to networking. Moving ahead, the second decision would be learn as much as you can. Do you remember in previous podcast we mentioned that there is a 12 to 14% reduction in the job and placement market, as hotels have gone through much with no occupancy for months to feeding over employment. So in this upcoming new normal, human resource managers are willing to focus on hiring the right kind of multi-skilled talent to work in their organizations, because it reduces the cost spent on each head, as they can use the remaining budget into the other hotel operations. So, as a hotelier, we need to focus more on reskilling and upskilling to remain worthy in this about-to-be competitive market. And honestly, there is no harm in keeping major focus on learning and development, because it is helping us to become multi-skilled, worthy, knowledgeable, and ready for the survival in this new normal. So, learn as much as you can. You can design your own learning path as per your field of interest and simply just go deep down into your field of interest or into your subject. Once you get that knowledge, you will automatically be able to convert it into a skill set, which will give you an advantage over others. So, if you want to know how you can design your own learning path, then we have already made a podcast for it, titled Quick Learning Tips of Front Office, in which we have taken front office as a field of interest and designed a learning path around it. So, listen that podcast and understand it, and you can start designing your own learning path too. Well, a link for that is also given below in the description. Just go through it and start learning. Now, the third decision would be build relevant skill sets. As we have already told you, to learn as much as you can. But learning is useless until and unless you start implementing it. So, don't just keep on learning, but start building a relevant skill set around it, because it will give you real-time advantages on the field and make you a worthy candidate for the respective job. So, here without talking about technicalities, just to convert your knowledge into a skill set, you should start observing about how you can use your knowledge into the real-time operations and get benefits from it. Simply, to make a skill set, you will need two things, which are information and observation. So, once you start learning, means you are gathering the information. And once you start observing, means you are building a skill set through it. So, to know it in the details, you should listen to our recommended podcast of Quick Learning Tips of Front Office. It will definitely help to clear your views. Let's get going. The fourth decision would be to win fast, discover your field of interest as early as possible. We have already seen many people in hospitality who don't know what they are doing. They still haven't found the specific field in which they actually like working and learning. So you shouldn't have to be that person. Discover your field of interest as early as possible and then start using different techniques to learn and understand that field well. The best time to discover your field of interest is while you are studying hotel management, because that's the time when you have enough space to understand and know about all the departments of the hotel. And things will become eventually easy to select as per your liking. So, once you found your heart in something which really excites you, then that's going to be your field of interest. Just stick with it and keep growing. That will help you to win fast in the hospitality. But remember one thing, it's never too late. If you have not found it during your college days, then start searching for it now. Because our ultimate goal is to win this game. And finding your field of interest would be the first step. The fifth decision would be, don't let opinions hold you back. Everyone are having some kind of opinions about us. Well, some are good and some are bad. Just appreciate good opinions and never let the bad opinions hold you back. Because one thing is clear, mistakes will be happening and people will be saying bad things about us. But we have to understand that it's part of learning. When we do mistake, our seniors will say bad words to us. Sometimes we are threatened for our jobs too. Hearing bad opinions would be very harmful for our self-respect. But that's how we grow. If people won't tell us about our mistakes, then how come we would be able to correct it? So, if you are a hospitality student or a working professional, keep this thing in your mind that never fear mistakes. If you do it, then always try to analyze it and learn from it. Just never let it to hold you back. That's it. Very important decision coming up, the sixth one. The sixth decision would be, put in the work. Think about it carefully. Earlier taken all the decisions would be useless if you don't put in the work. Because you will get experience by actually experiencing things. This is another great way to keep up the learning. Love what you do. Be a constant learner and always put in the work. Stay consistent with this process and your all deeds will be flourished. Now moving ahead, this seventh decision is not so related with the hospitality industry. But we thought this decision plays an important role in every hotelier's life. So it's better to make this decision as a priority. Now, the seventh decision is manage your money well. We believe that there are many opportunities in hospitality to earn well. If you are working as an attendant or manager, you both can earn as per your capabilities or service skills. But here, we are talking about managing your money rather than earning it. So, you should be focused on spending your money for assets rather than liabilities. You can spend your money for your family, which brings you happiness. You can spend your money for travel, which brings you experience. You can spend your money for books or courses, which brings you knowledge. And those are the kind of assets which will help you to create more money from it. So, simply understand the difference. Don't just waste your salaries after fancy mobile phones or bad junk food habits, pampering yourself with gadgets and all. Make thoughtful investments which will help you to grow as a person. Now, let me remind you again, all the best decisions to make as a hotelier. So, start noting it down. Number 1. Give importance to networking. Number 2. Learn as much as you can. Number 3. Build relevant skill sets. Number 4. To win fast, discover your field of interest as early as possible. Number 5. Don't let opinions hold you back. Number 6. Put in the work. And number 7. Importantly, manage your money well. And that is it for today. We wish you all the very best and thank you for listening today's podcast of Hospitality Connoisseur. To know more about who we are, simply visit us online at hospitalityconnoisseur.com. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay tuned. Here, learning never stops. We are Hospitality Connoisseur. Let's grow together.